Let me share with you 10 tips and tricks using Canva that's gonna make Canva a whole lot better. The very first tip is you could actually copy a color palette from one design and apply it to a whole different design. It's really easy to do. Here's a design I have, it's a template. All I have to do is come to the Styles tab right over here. I'm under the Design tab and Styles. If I go all the way to the bottom, under Image Palette, if I click on See All, here's all the different palettes here that is part of this design. So if I go to a page later on that doesn't have that, I could just go ahead and click on it like this, and it's gonna go ahead and apply it to my design. Tip number two is an AI color changer that actually analyzes an image and gives you a color palette based on that. So let's say I just choose this image right over here. With this selected, all I have to do is go to the Design tab. And if I go to the Style tab over here and scroll down, here's the image and here's the color palette from that same image here. So I could go ahead and select this color palette. And if I create a new page and it has this kind of design to it, what I could do is I could go to that image palette, just click on it, and it's gonna apply what the AI picked up from this image to my presentation to make everything nice and seamless in design. Next one allows you to bring things from your Instagram directly into your design. It's under the app section here from the homepage. And if you just search for the Instagram app here, and you could directly connect to the Instagram app from here. I'm gonna go ahead and create a new design. And it's gonna pull up your Instagram directly here, connect to it. And if you look on the left side, now everything, including videos and photos from my Instagram accounts, can be pulled directly into my design. So I could just go ahead and resize it just like any other image. But if you use things from your Instagram, this will save you a ton of time. Next one is an entire mockup library that Canva has. If you go to the app section here, you'll see on the left side a mockup library. So there is a bunch of different things that you could start to design with and just drop images right into those placeholders. And they have different categories like print, packaging, apparel, home and living. I'll start here with technology. Here's one with a phone. I'll click on that. And look at all these different types of phones they have. So let's say I'll choose this one here. Here's a free one we could use. I'll select it. And I'll select this design. And it's gonna bring me over here where I could actually choose anything from my own photo library. So I'll just go in and choose this photo here, select it and upload it to that design. And look at that, how easy was that? And I could go ahead and save this mockup, or I could go ahead and adjust the image here if I wanna move it up, for example, go ahead and press save and get a different design out of it this way. Now this next one lets you really organize everything you see and line it up really nice and simple with one click. Tidy up and position is our next tip. All you have to do is select everything you see on your canvas. Right now, I just have a bunch of different stickers I put from the Elements tab. If I right click on it, it lets me space them evenly, but this one lets me tidy up right here. Let me click on that, and it just does a nice job by scanning your document here and actually lining things up. Now, the next tip lets you group different things. So in this case, all these different texts, if I want to move everything just slightly up, it's going to take me a long time. So all I have to do is select something and click on this position tab and then go to this layer tab right here. So this is going to show you pretty much everything that you see. And on the top layer are all these different text layers. So if I select these different text layers and if I hold down shift, I could select many text layers like this. And now all the text layers are selected and I just have to go ahead and group them together like this. So now they move as one group. So if I just move this around, you could see they're moving as one group. Now these also should be part of that group. So I'm gonna go ahead and ungroup that. And this time I'm gonna select these and I'm gonna come down here and I'm gonna also hold command and select these as well. So let me go ahead and group these. And now if I move this whole thing, okay, now they're moving together much, much better. And I could, again, add this to my group too if I want to move that with it. Or in this case, this is really easy. I could just go ahead and do it. But you could see if you did this manually, it will take quite a long time. So grouping and making sure everything that you want to move stays together is a great shortcut. Next, I'm gonna show you how to copy the effects of one text into another. So let's say I created this text. I like the outline. I like the curve that I applied to it. So if I go ahead and start a new text over here, this is not gonna have any of that, right? So to apply it from this one to this one, all I have to do is select it, go over here, click on copy style. And then if I select this box right here, just like that, I get all the same styles, including outline, curves, and everything else. And this is fully editable on its own, independent from this one now. Now you could also turn anything into a video inside of Canva. So here I have just a presentation, nothing is moving. All I have to do is to actually turn this into video is select the different parts of it and then go up here and click on Animate. And Animate lets me go ahead and create different kind of motion for each of the elements. And I could change all kinds of different things, including some of the paid options that lets you even change the direction and speed here. But I'm just covering all the free options here. Oh, this one's really, really nice. And I could click on every single element here and then go ahead and add a little bit of motion. So now this is technically a video. So I could go ahead and save it like this as a video or go ahead and preview it right on top over here. Now, Canva is also a full-blown video editor. So I just uploaded a video here under this upload tab, and here's the video. You could actually edit videos right on this timeline down here. All I have to do is select this timeline, and if I want to make a cut right here, if I just press these three dots right here, it lets me split it. So now it's created a cut, and I could go a little bit further. Let's say I made a mistake right here. Again, I could go ahead and split that. Or you could just press S on your keyboard, which is a much faster way to edit. So that's going to split it. Now I could select the middle part and go ahead and press delete. And then if I want to apply any transitions between different clips here, I could go ahead and press the transition option. And I could go ahead and, for example, dissolve. So let me just show you what that looks like. If I go a little bit further, press play. There it is. That's a little dissolve. Or what I could do is I could actually add a page right over here and add something else entirely different. So I just get this brand new page over here. So I could go to my elements, for example, find whatever I want to add, go ahead and add it over here. So now my video could go from me talking to this image back to the video. This is a really, really simple way to edit any type of video right inside of Canva. And if you go to the app section of Canva and click on AI powered, Canva has a massive library of AI powered apps. So for example, if you wanted to turn anything into an anime, you could go ahead and click on this one, use in a new design, add a picture over here, go to the app section right here, go to your apps. This is the one I just added. Click on it just like this, replace. And just like that, it turned that image into an anime. And in the next video, I'll show you the top 10 AI powered apps. Some of them could create 3D avatars here that are completely AI powered with voices. DALL-E could create incredible images. This one could create music and a whole lot more. So I'll go ahead and link that here as soon as it's ready. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.